Dear student, warm welcome to NPTEL Phase 2 video course on Geosynthetics Engineering in Theory and Practice. My name is Professor J. N. Mandal, Department of Civil Engineering, Indian Institute of Technology, Bombay, Mumbai, India. This lecture number 33. Name of the course, Geosynthetics Engineering in Theory and Practice. This module 6, lecture 33, Geosynthetics for Reinforced Soil Retaining Wall. I will just show you the recap of the previous lecture. We covered the Excel program for mechanically stabilized reinforced soil retaining wall, geotextile or geogrid wraparound face mechanically stabilized earth wall, general wraparound face construction, design of geotextile wraparound face wall that partly cover. Now, I will show you this table, and I will focus that how we have calculated the L of E and total L and the LT. For we have considered the 12 layer, 1 to 12. And depth we have taken 0.70 to 1.40. That means spacing for the layer 11 and 12 is 0.7 meter. And then 7 to 10 we have kept 0.45. And then from 1 to 6 is 0.3 meter. Spacing. Now, this is the L of E, which you call embedment length, and embedment length we have earlier calculated, that is L of E is equal to 0.81 divided by Z. At any particular depth, you can calculate that what is L of E. That means LE will be equal to 0.8 divided by Z. So we know the Z. So we can calculate the L of E. So this way you can calculate all the embedment length value LE. However, that embedment length minimum is required for 1 meter. That's why it has shown 1 meter. Then we calculated L of R, that LR is equal to H minus Z into tan 45 degree minus pi by 2. I have shown earlier. So you know at any depth, you can calculate the LR using the expression LR is equal to H minus Z into tan of 45 degree minus pi by 2. So you know what is Z. And you know the what is the height of the wall. So you know the pi value. So you can calculate what is L of R. Here L of R is calculated knowing the various Z value and height is constant. So this length, this is total length. The total length is equal to embedment length plus LR, and LE plus LR. So if you sum up LE plus LR, this will give L 3.4. Similarly, 0.58 plus 1.67872, this will give L value 2.9. Like this, you can calculate the total length of the reinforcement, the length of the reinforcement at various layers. So in this design, we have consider it that what will be the L obtained. So instead of 3.4 to 2.9, we obtain, we take it as a 4 meter. And this 1.9 to 2.6, we consider as a L obtained 3 meter. And 1.0 to 1.8, we obtain as a 2 meter. And L0, what you call the overlap length. So L0 is basically LE by 2. If you know the LE 1.16, so half of that will give the L0 value 0.58. Like that, you can calculate what is the L0 for other layers. But overlap length minimum is required 1 meter. So this is 1 meter. So this is the total length L, total is 5.7. This so that overlap length is 1 meter and this length is 4 meter, 4 plus overlap length 1, 5 plus spacing 0.7. And that is why this is 5.7. So similarly for this 7 to 10, this is 3 plus 1, 4 and spacing is 0.45. So total length will be 4.45. Like that, this is 2 plus 1, this is overlap length 3 plus spacing 0.3, that is why 3.45. So total length you can calculate. So you will be knowing that what quantity of geotextile material is required for the design of the geotextile reinforced soil wall. So this is the final arrangement of the geotextile reinforcement. And here you know the height of the wall is the 5 meter, and here is the first two layer is the 4 meter. So that is why it is a 4 meter length. That means two layer at rate of 0.70 meter spacing, that means this will give you 2 into 0.7, that means this height will be 1.4 meter. So this is from, you can see this table, because there are two layers. Okay, this length is 4 meter, this is 2 layer and this spacing is 0.7, 2 into 0.7, 1.4, and this length is 4 meter, length of the reinforcement. 4 meter, and this height is 2 into 0.7 mean 1.4 meter. Now next, you can see that this length is 3 meter, because this is length is 3 meter, and 3 meter and spacing is 0.45. So this is 0.45. Then you check the how many layer, 1, 2, 3, 4. So here you can calculate 4 layer at the rate of 0.45 of spacing, that means 4 into 0.45, which will give you that 1.8 meter. So this side is 1.8 meter, but this length of the reinforcement is 3 meter. Now next, the 2 meter length and spacing is 0.3 and layer is 1 to 6. So here this is 2 meter, this is 2 meter and this is 6 layer into 0.3 meter spacing. So 6 into 0.3, that means this height will be the 1.8 meter. So if you add 1.4 plus 1.8, plus 1.8, which will give you that 5 meter height of the wall. So, this way you can finally arrange the reinforcement in different layer. So, longer length on the top and then gradually it is decreasing at the bottom. And each zone has its own weight. Suppose this two layer is, if it is a weight is W1, for this four layer for 2 meter length, this weight is W2, and also for this six layer and weight is W3. And this weight is located from the facing of the element. For W1 it is distance is x1 from the facing element of the wall. Similarly, for W2 is the x2 and W3 is equal to x3. So, this may require when we will calculate the overturning moment. So, ultimately we show that what is the final arrangement of the geotextile reinforcement. Now, we will design the external stability, step 1. So, you have to find out what will be the stability against the sliding. So, you have seen that arrangement of the reinforcement, and this is the earth pressure. You have to calculate what will be the earth pressure behind the wall due to the existing backfill, that is P A will be equal to half K A into gamma B into H square. What is K? K is equal to 1 minus sin pi b by 1 plus sin pi b, and pi b value is 35 degree. So, K is equal to 1 minus sin 35 degree divided by 1 plus sin 35 degree is equal to 0.271. And gamma b value is given is 17 kilonewton per meter cube, which is given, and height of the wall is 5 meter. So, you can substitute this value here. K is equal to 0.271, gamma b is equal to 17, height is equal to 5. So, you can calculate what will be the earth pressure behind the retaining wall, that is P of A. And this wall also has a surcharge load. So, this wall may move this direction. So, that is why it is resisting force here, it will act the resisting force here. So, you have to calculate what will be the factor of safety against the sliding. The wall wants to move this direction and this is the resisting force. So, we first of all calculate what will be the earth pressure acting on this wall. So, P A we calculated, it gives 57.59 kPa. Now, this P A making as an angle of delta, so it has a two component, that is P A B and P A H. This is horizontal component, this is vertical component. So, vertical component of the earth pressure P A B will be equal to P A into sin of delta, and this H horizontal component of earth pressure is equal to P A into this is cos of beta. So, that way you calculate the what will be the P A B, 57.59 is the P A into sin of 35 degree, this give P A B vertical component of earth pressure 33.030 kilonewton per meter. Similarly, horizontal component P A H is 57.59 into cos 35 is 47.171 kilonewton per meter. So, we calculate what will be the vertical component, what will be the horizontal component. Now, we want to calculate what will be the weight, the W. So, W is equal to W1, W2, W3. So, we can calculate that W is equal to, this is W1, W2 and W3. So, here that W1 means that that weight of the input soil body, let us say this is the total weight W is equal to W1, W2 plus W of 3. So, weight of the reinforced solid body is expressed as W, W will be equal to what is W3. So, W3 will be equal to, this is 6 layer and 0.3 is the spacing. So, 6 into 0.3, 1.8 into this length is 2 into gamma r, that is 17. So, that means 6 into 0.3 into 2 into 17 for W3. Similarly, for WT will be equal to, this is, you see that there are 4 layers. So, 4 into 0.45 is the spacing, 4 into 0.45 and this length is 3 meter into 17 gamma, that means gamma into H into L. So, for WT you can calculate. Similarly, W1, this length is 4 and this height is 2 at the rate of 0.7, that means 1.4, then 2 into 0.7 into 4 meter into 17. So, if you calculate individually for W3, W2 plus W1, so this will give you that what will be the total weight. So, this total weight, that W, which we can say W1 plus W2 plus W of 3, this it will come 248.2 kilonewton per meter. So, you obtain this is the weight which is acting on the wall. Now, you have to go, what is the driving force due to the backfill soil, that means P of H. So, driving force again due to the surcharge, because there is a surcharge load Q. So, Q into K into H, H is equal to height of the wall. So, total driving force FD will be equal to PAH plus Q into K into H. That means PAH you have calculated 47.171 plus Q is the surcharge load is 15, K is equal to you calculated 2.271 and height of the wall H is 5. So, if you calculate, then total driving force FD will be equal to 67.496 kilonewton per meter. Similarly, total resisting force. So, resisting force. So, if you look here, this is the resisting force. The resisting force is acting along this. So, this resisting force, there is a C of A addition, and this is the bottom length is 2, that means this length is 2, this is 2 meter. So, this if you can say that this is the L of B, L of B, so CA into L of B, that is due to addition, plus there is a weight, that means W, plus there is a PAB, PAB component, vertical component PAB, this into tan of delta F, tan of delta F. So, this is the friction between the soil and the foundation soil. So, now you are substituting this value. So, we are substituting this value here. That means CA is given 17.6 and L bottom is 2 meter plus weight we calculated, that is 248.2 plus PAB we know, that is 33.03 into tan of 14.25, because delta A value is 14.25 degree. So, we calculate total resisting force FR is equal to 106.632 kilonewton per meter. So, you have to calculate the what will be the factor of safety against sliding. So, factor of safety against sliding is the ratio of FR by FD. That means what will be the resisting force divided by driving force. So, resisting force is 106.632 divided by driving force is 67.496 which will give 1.58 and which is greater than 1.5, so it is okay. Next, step 2, that overturning stability. So there is a possibility that structure can overturn like this, it may be overturned. So it has a weight and this weight is acting at a distance x from the toe. So we have to take the moment at this toe for the various forces. And this forces, horizontal force, is acting 1/3 of the height of the wall. If h is the height of the wall, so this pH is acting at a depth of 1/3 from the base of the wall. So you have to calculate what is overturning moment due to the back field, that is PAH into h by 3. PAH we know 47.171 into height of the wall 5 divided by 3, 76.618 kilonewton meter per meter. What is overturning moment due to the surcharge loading? So surcharge loading is equal to K into Q into h by h by 2, because this is a surcharge load which will be at the middle of the reinforcement. So this K is 0.271 into surcharge Q is 15, height is equal to 5 and h is equal to 5 meter, that is 5 divided by 2. So this will give overturning moment due to the surcharge loading is 50.8125 kilonewton meter per meter. So what will be total overturning moment, MOV, will be the summation of overturning moment due to backfill plus overturning moment due to surcharge loading. So overturning moment due to backfill is 78.618 plus overturning moment due to surcharge loading is 50.8125. So total overturning moment MOV will be equal to 129.43 kilonewton meter per meter. So now what will be the resisting moment due to the weight of the reinforced soil? So resisting moment will be equal to W into X. That means if this is the W3, so you are taking a moment at the toe. For this W3, this will be W3 into, suppose this distance from the toe is X3. So this is W3 into X3. Then for this waist is W2, and which is acting at a distance of X2 from the toe. So this is W2 into X2. Similarly, this weight is W1. So from this toe, it is acting at a distance of X1. So this will be the W1 into X1. So what will be the resisting moment? If you take a moment at this toe, that means W1 into X1 plus W2 into X2 plus W3 into X3. What you can say, X is the distance of a point of application of the weight reinforced zone from the toe of the wall. This is the toe of the wall. So now here, what is X3? X3, if this is a 2, X3 will be 2 by 2. So X3 will be, is 2 by 2 is equal to 1. What is W3? That means this weight. This weight will be, this is 1.8 meter, 1.8, this length is 2, 1.8 into 2 into gamma r, that is 17. That means W3 will be equal to 17. Let us say W3 is equal to 17 into 1.8 into 2. This is 1.8 and this is 2. So 1.8 into 2. So you know W3. So this give about 61.2 kilonewton per meter. Similarly, for W2, what is X2? This length is 3 meter. So X2 will be 3 by 2. So in this case, X2 will be 3 by 2. That means this is 1.5 meter. Then W2 will be equal to, this is also 1.8 meter, this length is 3 meter, so 1.8 into 3 into unit weight 17. So you can write 1.8 into 3 into 17. So this W2 value will be 91.8 kilonewton per meter. Now for W1, this length about 4 meter. So X1 will be, this X1 will be half of that 4. So that means this is 4 by 2 is equal to 2 meter. And W of 1 will be equal to, this is 1.4 into 4 into gamma r is 17. So 1.4 into 4 into gamma r 17. So this W1 will be 95.2 kilonewton per meter. So we know that weight, we know that the distance x1, from at what distance is located from the toe of the wall. We know for W3, we know for W2, and also we know for W3. Hence, resisting moment will be W3 into X3, W2 into X2 plus W1 into X1. So here you can see W3 61.2 into X3 is 1 plus W2 is 91.8 into X2 is equal to 1.5 plus W1 is equal to 95.2 into X1 is equal to 2. So total resisting moment due to the weight of the reinforced soil is 389.3 kilonewton meter per meter. Similarly, resisting moment due to earth pressure, that is PAV into L. This is the vertical and this is the length of the reinforcement at the top. So this is 33.03 into this length, top is 4. So this will give 132.12 kilonewton meter per meter. So total resisting moment, that is MR, will be equal to 389.3 plus 132.12. So this is 521.42 kilonewton meter per meter. Now we calculate what will be the factor of safety against overturning, that is MR by MOV. We know what is MR, resisting moment. So resisting moment is 521.42, this divided by overturning moment MOV 129.43, this will give, this factor of safety against overturning is 4.03. So that is greater than 2.5, that means it is okay. So you have checked the factor of safety against the sliding, you have checked that factor of safety against this overturning. So it satisfies this criteria. Now step 3, you have to check for bearing capacity, that means this foundation soil here. So there is a possibility for the failure surface due to the bearing capacity of the soil. Even the foundation soil is poor, then you have to check what will be the factor of safety against bearing capacity. Now we know the ultimate bearing capacity of foundation soil. Let us say P ultimate, you know this equation, this very standard equation, P ultimate is equal to C of F into NC plus 0.5 gamma of F into L length at the bottom into N gamma. So this C of F NC and the N gamma value is given. That is NC value 12.9, N Q value 4.4, N gamma value 2.5, this from the bars 1982 for the friction angle of pi r is 15 degree. So for this value, so you know that what is NC and what is N gamma. Here it is required only NC and N gamma. So this is CF is given 22. Into NC, NC value 12.9 plus 0.5 into gamma f is 18 is given. L bottom, that is 2 meter, that is why L bottom 2 meter, and n gamma is 2.5, this is 2.5. So you know what will be the ultimate bearing capacity of the foundation soil, or P ultimate is 328.8 kilonewton per meter square. So you know what is ultimate bearing capacity. Now what is total vertical pressure over the foundation soil? So that is Q of actual, that you know what will be the height of the wall, you know what will be the gamma r, plus D to the surcharge load is Q. So gamma r is equal to 17 into height is 5 meter plus Q surcharge is 15. So 17 into 5 plus 15 is equal to 100 kilonewton per meter square. So we check what will be the factor of safety against bearing capacity, that is ratio of Q ultimate divided by Q actual. That means 328.8 divided by 100 is equal to 3.288, that is greater than 2, that means it is okay. So factor of safety against bearing capacity also okay. So we have checked that what will be the factor of safety against the sliding, factor of safety against the overturning, also factor of safety against the bearing capacity. Also you have to check what will be the factor of safety against the global stability. There are commercially available this computer program, so you can make use of the program and can check also that what will be the factor of safety against this overturning, and it should be about 1.3. So if that satisfies, then the structure is safe, because sometimes there is a possibility for the failure due to the global stability or the deep seated stability. So we complete this example, and now you know how to design the wraparound face geocentric reinforced soil wall. This is the geotextile wraparound wall. This in 19-year centrifuge modeling, you have used the non-oven geotextile material. This is about 5 to 6 meter height, and you can see this is the geotextile material have been wrapped. Even then, if it is tear it up and there is a possibility for growing the grass, so it looks also greenery. So this is the geotextile around wall with the growing vegetation. Initially here also these contractor does not like to go ahead with the geotextile wrap around system wall. They wanted to go for the reinforced concrete system, and ultimately we saved about 55% with respect to the conventional reinforced concrete retaining wall. So here that welded wall mesh facing with geogrid geotextile wrap and vegetated erosion control have shown. Here you can see this is the geogrid material, also it can be wrapped like this, this dot dot from dotted, and because there is a opening of the geogrid material, so there is a possibility that soil may comes out from the geogrid. So you can provide with a some small piece of the geotextile material or the natural jute material also here. And this is the number of the layer of the geogrid and spacing about 0.6 meter. There is also the drainage at the back with the two vertical to one horizontal. You can provide with the geocomposite material at the back of the wall and also at the base. And this length is about 1.5 meter. So you can provide this welded wire mesh like this, is a kind of L shape like this, you can provide the welded wire mesh. Why you are providing the welded wire mesh? It's about 1.2 meter, and this is 1.5 meter, because this geogrid material may be damaged, or sometimes any animal can attack, then there is a possibility for damage of the geogrid material. So we provide with the welded wire mesh. Nowadays also this system also going on, welded wire mesh, and at the same time that here you can provide with the fertilizer kind of the soil at the facing element, and then the grass can grow. So easily can grass can grow. So even then the welded wire mesh, grass comes out and this structure looks like a greenery. So this system also can be adopted. So these are all about this geocentric reinforced soil retaining wall. So we cover that how you can design the mechanically stabilized reinforced soil retaining wall. It is in the form of a wraparound face reinforced soil retaining wall, and also that you have used also the panel or the block, so you know the how to design this mechanically stabilized reinforced soil system. Now part 3 we will discuss the gabion wall and the geocell wall. Now this will cover general, then gravity gabion wall design, reinforced soil gabion wall design, and apart from that we also cover the feasibility study on the fly ash on as a backfill material, whether the what kind of the fly ash is suitable for the backfill material. This is very important to us. You cannot use any kind of the fly ash material as a backfill material, and how you have to compact, what kind of the moisture content and density will be required. And also apart from that, we also will cover the geocell wall design. This is one new innovative system is coming up, so this we can also cover in our course. Now this gabion basically like this kind of the material. It is a galvanized mild steel, or you can use welded resistant hexagonal. You can see this is hexagonal wire mesh in the form of, you can also have in the form of cube, also in the form of the rectangular, and this is like a 1 meter by 1 meter a cube. So gabion box, or you can make the basket, and these are filled with the round rock or the rubble or quarried stone, and it is highly permeable material. And the stone must be insoluble, hard, weather resistant, and non-fireable, and of hard specific gravity. The mild steel should be coated with the, this is the polyvinyl chloride, that is called PVC, to prevent the corrosion of the steel. Also we know that when we will use this kind of the gabion or the hexagonal shape of the gabion, then we should know what will be the tensile strength in the longitudinal direction, what will be the tensile strength in the transverse direction, and also what will be the strain in the longitudinal direction, and also in the transverse direction. Apart from that, the are to calculate what will be the what is the diameter of the galvanized mild steel and what will be the tensile strength of the mild steel. Apart from that, you should know, because it will be the corroded, so you have to check the effect of the corrosion, which we have covered in our testing, that how you can say that what will be the suitability of the material for the use for the construction of the retaining wall. This gabion as a retaining wall. So these are the property is important, and also at the same time when you are covering with the PVC kind of the material, this also you have to be checked. So it takes lot of time, that salt spray technique. You take maybe more than 1500-3000 hours and with a high temperature. So this is very important, that because that otherwise this PVC will be the spoiled. So what there is a salt, you have to be very careful. So this kind of the gabion can be used for the retaining wall and also the erosion control or river bank protection, etc. So this here is showing that some of the gabion. So this is 1 meter and this also 1 meter. So this is 1 meter like a cube. So you can have like this, or you can have this also 1 meter and this is like a 0.5 meter. So you can have a bucket like this. Also you can have, this is 2 to 3 meter and this is 1 meter and this height is 0.5 meter. So you can have the different shape and configuration of the gabion material. So individual gabion basket are tied together with the help of a strong spiral blinder or wire to form the retaining wall. So buckets are placed in a multiply layer until it achieves the desired height. The layer can be placed to form a better space of vertical step wall. Gabion wall can be designed as simple gravity retaining wall or as reinforced soil gabion wall. In case of reinforced soil gabion wall, the flat welded wire mesh layer will be act as a soil reinforcement layer, or the backs of gabion wall. So you can construct a wall only you can provide with the gabion 1 meter by 1 meter cube. You can place horizontally like this, and then you can reduce the length of the gabion and you can construct, let us say 4 meter, then to 3 meter, then to 2 meter and then to 1 meter. So you can construct a gabion wall like this. So this is what we call simple gravity retaining wall. And sometimes this gabion itself will act as a facing element. So 1 meter by 1 meter and then another, if you place 1 meter by 1 meter on the top of that, and in place there is a layer of the reinforcement material. So we will cover and also we will give example and we will show how we can design that simple that gravity retaining wall and also the reinforced soil gabion wall. Gabion wall is facing and this reinforcement will, which will be attached with the gabion wall, that design we'll show you. So design of gabion wall is conservative. The following assumptions are made. The passive thrust acting at the toe of the wall is not taken into account for stability analysis. When the gabion wall is designed as gravity retaining wall, its own weight resists the lateral earth pressure. The Coulomb method is used to determine the active thrust coefficient. So, here three types of this wall is shown, and one is the vertical, this is vertical gravity wall, and also one is so that inclined step back face, this is inclined step back face. Here you can see that when the vertical, this is absolutely the vertical retaining wall. So, this is a kind of the box, you can place box, number of the box. Then you reduce one box, then you place next layer. Then you reduce another box, then you can place. Like this, you can construct a gravity wall or gabion retaining wall. And this is the failure surface, and if there is a surcharge, that is VC, which is making at an angle I, and this is the failure line. Okay. And then we have to calculate what the pressure is acting on this wall. So, this is 90 degree. Also, you can have this inclined step back face. Also, I can show you that inclined step front face. This is inclined step back face. So, here I just mentioned that if this is the failure and BC, this is the weight of the wedge, and this the WG is the weight of the gabion, and here R is the resultant of the normal force and the shearing resistant force at the failure surface, this is AC, and act at an angle of pi to the normal force, and pi is the angle of internal friction of the soil, and this is the I, this is the backfill surface BC, which is inclined with the horizontal, and this alpha angle, this is acute angle of the back face of the wall with vertical. That is why this plus alpha. If it is a front face, then this will be the negative alpha. I will show you. And delta is the angle of wall friction, and this P of A is the active earth pressure force per unit length of the wall. So, it has a two component, that is PAH, which is making at an angle of delta here, and this is the P of B. So, this term is the same for all other cases also. So, here that this is the negative, this alpha, this is inclined step front face. So, it is a negative, this here alpha. So, it may be the positive when it is the back face, it is negative when it is the front face, and other parameters are etcetera are the same. So, all three cases it is the same, whether it is a vertical, whether it is inclined step front face, whether it is inclined step back face. Now, this is the reinforced soil gabion wall. So, here is the reinforced soil gabion wall. So, this is the gabion wall, and this is the reinforcement, number of the layer of the reinforcement. This number of the layer of reinforcement attached with the gabion. So, earlier we saw only the gabion itself is forming a retaining wall. Now, gabion here only act as a facing element, and then the number of the layer of reinforcement are placed here, and there is also the surcharge load is Q. So, height of the wall that is designated Hg, and this is alpha, which wall inclined with the particle, this wall inclined with the particle, and this is the failure line which is making at an angle of 45 degree plus pi by 2. This also reinforcement at the metallic mesh as a reinforcement you can add. And L of E, it is the embedment length of the metallic strip, and here that spacing between the two metallic strip reinforcement is designated as SB. And this is the thickness, that is TG is the thickness of the gabion facing, and this is the L is the width of the wall. So, if this angle is alpha and this height is h, so this distance will be hg tan of alpha. So, you can construct a wall like this. So, now we show design of the gravity gabion wall. So, how can design the gravity retaining wall? So, this is the wall, gravity retaining wall, and here this wall height is H, and we have a surcharge load is Q, and backfill slope angle is, let us say, I, angle of friction between the wall and soil is delta, and wall inclined with the vertical is alpha, and let us say soil friction angle is equal to pi, soil density is equal to gamma s, gabion fill as a density is equal to gamma of g, and soil also bearing pressure, which we can say Q of allowable, and scale correction factor is Ci, and maximum total base width is L, generally 0.7 times the height of the wall. And here it should be noted that this is A, B, C, D, E. So, this is the width of the gabion. You can see there are two layers of the gabion, and whose width is A. After this, you can see the two layer of gabion whose width is B. After that, again two layer of gabion whose width is C. After that, two layer of gabion whose width is D. After that, one layer of gabion whose width is E. So, this you have to remember, because like that you can construct a gravity gabion wall. Suppose that each is the 7 meter, then this is, if the gabion wall is 1 meter and 2 layer, 2 meter. So, 1 meter, 1 meter, then again 1 meter, 1 meter, 4 meter, then 5, 6 meters, 7, 8, 9, 10, like that you can make a gabion wall at any height. Now, design step. Now, step 1, calculation of total earth pressure and its point of application. You have to find out that what will be the active earth pressure coefficient, that is Ka. And according to the Coulomb's equation, you can calculate this Ka with this equation. K is equal to cos square pi minus alpha divided by cos square alpha into cos square delta plus alpha into 1 plus root of sine pi plus delta into sine pi minus I divided by cos delta plus alpha into cos I minus alpha, where I is the backfill soil slope and delta is the angle of friction between wall and the soil, and alpha is the wall inclination with the vertical, and pi is the soil friction angle. So whatever the value will be given, I delta and alpha and pi, you can just substitute this value here, then you can calculate the k. Sometimes that is backfill of the slope angle is not there, then I will be the 0, or wall inclined vertical is not there, then alpha will be 0. So this equation you have to adopt for the determination of the earth pressure coefficient k of A. Now total active thrust on the wall PA will be equal to K into gamma S H square divided by 2 plus Q into H, that is due to the surcharge load also. So H is equal to wall height along the inclined of the wall. So here considering the wall friction angle delta is equal to 0, active earth pressure forces act normal to the slope of the back face at a vertical distance of h by 3 above the backfill base. When the surcharge is there and wall is inclined at an angle alpha, then vertical distance of the point of application, the resultant force PA from the toe is equal to h of y. So where HB is equal to vertical depth of the, I am showing you here, that is the H of B is equal to vertical depth of the back field, that is H into cos alpha, this angle is alpha. I say H of the wall height, so this will be the H cos alpha, and alpha is the wall inclination with the vertical, and gamma S, you know, that is the what you call soil density. And you have to determine what is the H of Y, because this PA, which is acting at a distance from this base, so you have to calculate what is HY. So this HY will be equal to HV divided by 3 into H gamma plus 3Q by gamma S divided by HB plus 2Q by gamma S. So this is from the geometry of this, you can calculate that what should be the HY. So this HY, because you know this and you know this is alpha, so this will be the L of sine of alpha. So this HY will be from here to here, this minus of L of sine alpha. So HY will be the this minus L of sine alpha. So this will give you what will be the value of HY. So this you can obtain from the geometry of the gabion structure. So for this gravity retaining wall, so you have understood that what will be the different types of the gabion retaining wall. Retaining wall with gabion, it will act as a facing element, and then also the gabion itself will act as a gravity wall. So you know some theory behind this, how to calculate the total active thrust on the wall and at what distance. With this, I finish this lecture today. Let me hear from you any question. Thank you for listening.